So the big question regarding language is whether humans are born with it or not. It's called the innateness of language. Well, one thing for sure, we have found areas in the human brain that must exist for us to speak. The two main areas are known as Broca's area and Wernicke's area. Broca's area is responsible for generating proper sentences. Wernicke's area is responsible for producing meaningful sentences. Any major damage to one of these regions in the left hemisphere will likely impair one's ability to talk. For people who use sign languages, the impact is the same. Just like speakers, signers also lose the ability to talk properly if the language areas are damaged. Okay, so because we have these language areas, we are able to talk. But there seems to be a time limit for a person to acquire language. If a child is not exposed to language by the time she is a teenager, the chances are she won't be able to have language for the rest of her life. This is called the critical period hypothesis. No matter how smart we are or whether we are born with the ability to utilize language, we will not be able to speak or sign unless we are exposed to language when we are little children. But this doesn't necessarily apply to just the language. Imagine the eyes of a child not getting exposed to any light for the first 10 years of his life. He will definitely go blind despite the fact that he was born with two perfectly fine eyes. So in a way, language can be considered a natural sense like vision or hearing. In other words, language is innate. To learn more, check out the next video from the bilingual or order a copy of The Birth of Language.
Would you like to learn more about language? Then get a copy of The Birth of Language from Amazon, Apple Books, or Google Play Books.